Okay, so we already talked about system calls. Okay, in fact, I said think about the cost of a system call compared to a regular call. So systems calls allow you to go from user mode to OS or the system mode. So let's talk a little bit more about system calls. First of all, they're used to transfer control between user and system code, or execution that must happen in user mode and system mode. The interesting thing about these calls are that they cannot be arbitrary. These are a set of calls that user-level code is allowed to make. Okay, this is defined by the application programming interface or the API that your operating system provides. So you have these calls, and these calls have to come into the operating system in a controlled fashion. Okay, so we said these calls are different than regular calls. They have to come through what is called, used to be called call gates. These are sort of special ways in which you can enter from user to, it's a defined way, transition from user to system level. You come through these call gates. And what happens as a result of that is, well, we know that it's a call, so we're going to return at some point. So we have to keep track of where we're going to return and the user code once the system call completes. But the processor execution mode has to change as a result of that, isn't it? We're going from user mode to system mode. So the privilege ring or the mode is going to change. And we're actually going to be able to, we'll have to change some memory mappings, data structures that keep track of those, because we're going to be able to access memory now that we couldn't access before. So some registers have to be saved, others have to be loaded, and things like that. So all that work has to be done. So now we are executing in a different protection domain. In fact, this used to happen through sort of an interrupt or a trap into the system from user mode. But in x86, you actually have explicit instructions. This is different from your regular call return. These are execute a system call, that's sysenter, enter the system or the operating system. And when you're done, you return by doing this another special instruction called sysexit. So there are these instructions that help you implement these system calls that we're talking about. Keep in mind that they are more expensive because now we're doing this work that we didn't have to. We had to check what kind of call it is, arguments that are being passed, save information when we come back, and change memory mapping so we can access things that we couldn't before, use these special instructions rather than the regular ones and so on. So that's what makes it costlier or more expensive.